If the computer that's running your AF server and the computer running SQL Server that's storing the AF structure are on different computers and they're separated on different domains that don't have a trust, you'll probably end up configuring SQL Server security instead of the normal default Windows integrated security. Now, if you're going to do that, we do have some step-by-step instructions you'll find in the AF 2010 User's Guide. So it's currently on page 290. It's the section called Using SQL Server Security. And you'll find instructions for doing the three different things that are required. First, turning on mixed mode authentication in SQL Server. Second is to create a specific user that's going to be in SQL Server, a SQL Server user that's going to be configured properly. And then finally, there is a configuration string that we use for making the connection. And in that configuration string, you'll notice we can specify either SQL Server or integrated security. Now, here's an example of what it looks like on my machine. I'm currently using the regular Windows integrated security. You'll find this in the PyPC/AF directory. It's this afserver.exe.config. What you're going to be doing is you're going to be reconfiguring this connection string that you see right here. You're going to configure that as shown in the book. Now, of course, if you're not the person within your organization that's the manager of the SQL Server database, you'll probably have to get them involved at this point. Now, also, please feel free to give us a call on technical support. We do have a great deal of experience working with folks that have a variety of configurations, even those things that may not be described in these, you know, in the AF User's Guide. Now, another issue is how the Pi System Explorer and any AF client is going to be able to connect to the AF server. Now, if you remember earlier during the install, I believe I mentioned that the Pi clients, or the AF clients, like Pi System Explorer, they're all using Windows Communication Foundation, you know, as the mechanism for communicating with AF. And generally, with Windows Integrated Security, that's not going to be a problem. That's going to be handled for you automatically. However, again, if you're clients are in a different domain, or if you know the clients in a work group and the AF servers in a domain, then you're going to end up having to implement the simplest of Windows securities, which is when you have two computers that both have the same username and the same password, and you have to ensure that the same user and password exist on both the client machine and the AF server. And that typically will work if you're in that environment. However, there is a gotcha that's fairly well documented, and you'll see has to do with the defaults. There's a nice section, by the way, in your manual that covers this section on troubleshooting that we're looking at right now. If you take a look at this section, we mentioned this one setting that has to be set. Let me show you where this is. It's under Administration, Tools, under the Local Security section. It's this option right here, this network access under local policies, security options. And by default, that's going to be set to basically specify only guests, or all the incoming connections are going to be connecting as guests instead of the classic behavior. We need you to set this back to that classic behavior if you're going to be using this, as I said, this lowest level of Windows security in which you have the name and the password, the username and password, the same on both machines. So again, you'll find more about this if you take a look at the troubleshooting section in your AF User's Guide. Yes, it's right under here, configuring Pi System Explorer and the AF server to allow communications. Remember, the Pi System Explorer is an AF client, so if it can communicate, then any other AF client can communicate.